Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can pass string into a function with the help of pointer. Before start, if you go to description of this video, you will find various links related to C language playlist. Those are available on my YouTube channel. So you can follow them if you want to learn C programming. Now coming on to this topic. So first of all, I am going to declare a function, then I will be implementing main function and then the definition of user defined function. So this is the declaration of function. So here you can see name of function is length. So we are going to calculate how many characters are available in a string by passing that string into function with the help of pointer. So here you can see this parameter type is character pointer. So I will be passing character array into a function, and that character array will be received through a pointer. So that's why its declaration is containing character pointer. And the length which I'm going to calculate will be in terms of integer. So that's why you can see return type of this function is integer. Now after this declaration, I am writing main function, then I am going to declare a string, and let's say I am writing India. So this way I am initializing this string with the value India. So you need to use name of a character array, then square bracket, then equals to sign, and inside double quotes you will put any character collection. So these character collection will be stored inside this character array, right? Now I am going to declare an integer variable. So let's say its name is L. So it will be receiving the return or calculated length. Then I am going to call this function and passing string into it. So here I am passing str, that is character array, as an argument. So this is input for this length function, and this is the calling statement of length function, right? And after completion of the process of this length function, the return value will be available to this L variable. So after this, I can write printf length equals to %d, and here I can print L, and then I can close main function. Right here you can notice I have initialized this character array myself. I didn't receive anything from the user. So in your requirement, if you want to read values from user, so you can remove this double quotes India from here, and after this character array declaration you can write printf scanf function so that you can read values from the user. Right, so these are optional things. If you want to read values from user, then you can apply that as well. If you want to give values by yourself, then you can remove those printf scanf and you can write the statement like this. Right, so here you can see main function is completed. Now I am going to write definition of this length function. So in length, and here I am writing character pointer and then opening the curly brace. So this str will be passed into this character pointer, and here I am naming this character pointer as p, right? So p will be having the base address of this character. So how it will be working? So I am writing the complete code, then with the help of example I will be explaining you how this p pointer can access all the elements of this character array that is available in str. So here I am declaring two variables, one variable, that is int l, and I am initializing it with 0, so it will be calculating length. Then I am writing while asterisk p not equals to null. So I hope you know whenever we create any string, so after assigning values to that string, at the end of that string, null character stores automatically, right? So here you can see I am checking this condition. If asterisk p is not equals to none, it means we have a valid character. But if asterisk p is equals to null, it means we are at end of string, so that we can terminate the loop. So that's why this condition is available here. And inside this condition, I am just incrementing value of l by 1 and incrementing value of p by 1 and closing this. Right? So length variable is incremented and p pointer is also incremented. And after termination of this loop, I am going to return value of l. So this value will be returned here and then output will be displayed. Right? So this is the code that will work by passing string into function using pointer. Now I am going to tell you how it will be working. So let's say here I am creating character array. So it is having India as input. This is null character. These are indexes. So these are values. These are indexes. And here I am writing addresses. Right? So I hope you know, whenever we declare any character variable or character array, so character variable occupies one byte, and character array, if we declare character array, so each location of that character array also occupies one byte of memory. So that's why you can see each block is having only one address. 101 is for this, 102 is for this, 103 for this location, and so on. And remember that I have assumed these addresses. These are not actual addresses. So whenever you will be implementing this in your laptop or in your desktop, so these addresses can differ, right? So I am assuming these addresses. India, I have initialized here, that's why I have mentioned. And indexes always start from 0, so that's why I am using these. Now, we have a pointer p which is declared here. So whenever we call any function, so control automatically transfers to its definition. So str will be passed into this p. And I hope you know, whenever we use name of any array, so name of array automatically provides its base address. So this is our array whose name is str. And if you are passing str into p pointer, it means str will provide its base address to the pointer automatically. So base address of this str is 101. Base address means beginning address of the location, and that will be available into p pointer, right? And pointer, I hope you all know pointer. So pointer is a variable which can store address of any location, and through that stored address we can access value of the location, right? So through p we can access the value which is stored inside 101 address. And for that, I am using this asterisk p, right? So now I am going to iterate this loop. So here you can see asterisk p is mentioned. So asterisk means, if I write meaning of asterisk, so asterisk means value at address. So what is the address? 101. So asterisk p means asterisk 101. It means value at 101. So 101 is having capital I. So capital I not equals to null. So condition is true. I is not equals to null. So L will be incremented by 1 and P will be incremented. So now again you need to understand how pointer increments. So P is having 101 and we are incrementing it by 1. So pointer is of type character. So if pointer's type is character, then whenever you increase that pointer, so it will automatically increase the address which is stored inside it by 1, because each character variable occupies 1 byte of memory. So whenever we increase this p pointer, so it will increase the value, or you can say the address which is stored inside it by 1. So 101 will become 102. If we are implementing the program for integer array, so for 16-bit compiler, it will increase addresses by 2. And for 32-bit compilers, it will increase addresses by 4. So as per the data type, the addresses which are stored in pointer increases. So now P is pointing to 102. So if again we dereference it asterisk P. So right now P is pointing to 102. So asterisk means value at address. So value at 102 is N, and N is not equals to null. So again condition is true. So L will be incremented and P will be incremented. So this way P will now point to 103, then 104, 105, 106. When P will be pointing to 106, then this condition will become false, and whatever value will be available into L, that will be returned into this L variable, and through this printf, the length will be printed on output screen. So this way, I hope you understood how we can pass character arrays into function, and inside that function, we can receive base address of that character array into a pointer, and through that pointer, we can iterate the complete string or character array till this null character, right? So I hope you understood how we can pass strings into function with the help of pointers. And if you want to watch more C programming related videos, so you can go to description of this video where you can find links of various playlists, so you can follow that. And I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. Thank you for watching this video.